My name is Donald Dixon. I live in Washington. It's been about 2 months since I've been here. I hope you've missed me.
I have.
Thank you, Stan. I'm here to talk about the jail briefly before I'm cut off on my time. I want to bring up first thing. Since I was here last time, I heard a news report that the state has finally closed all the jails that are going to close in North Carolina. They're not closing any more jails in North Carolina. After that, I called every prison and jail from Raleigh to the Outer Banks, and I asked them 3 questions. I wanted to know what their capacity was. I wanted to know what their daily average of prisoners was. And I wanted to know whether or not they rented space out to the feds and the state, or the state. To cut this short, I found it surprising that Pitt County, their detention center is 18 miles away. They've got 1,000 beds. They only fill up 500 of them. So they're half empty all the time. They told me right there on the phone they'd love to have our prisoners. Because a jail is just like a hotel. If they're not full, they're not making money. But in a jail, if you're not full, you're wasting a lot of money. Because what are you doing? You're having to steal heat and air conditioning and keep lights on and have jailers all the time for prisoners you don't have. Take Hyde County, for example. They had to build a new jail because theirs was flooded during the hurricane. They were originally, I think they could hold 12 prisoners. They increased it to 36. They could hold 36 prisoners. 7 years ago, they've never had a prisoner in their jail in 7 years. Because the county commissioners decided they couldn't afford to hire jailers for the added space. So they couldn't hire jailers, they couldn't put prisoners in it. The sheriff's department and the dispatch were working out of their special room in the detention center. Well, because they didn't keep the heat and air conditioning on, they got mold. So they had to move the dispatch and the sheriff's office out, who were working in a trailer behind their new building, while they tear the walls and ceiling out of their new building, because they couldn't keep the heat and air on. They couldn't do what they were supposed to do. What I'm trying to say, folks, is if you're trying to rent space out to the feds or the state to pay for this jail, it's going to be a losing proposition completely. There are empty jails everywhere in North Carolina. You look at Greenville. Why would they bring them here to Beaufort County if you build a jail 3 times bigger than what we need? It doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense at all. They've already closed them all, and Pitt County's still 50% empty. We would be better off to send all our prisoners to Pitt County and shuffle them back and forth. What I would suggest is keep the jail like we've got. There's nothing wrong with it. Everything that was wrong with the jail and the complaints and the catastrophe they had with the jail was all man-made because of poor management is all it was. The only thing we can't control is overcrowding. My suggestion is, and if I'm sheriff, this is what I'll do, when we get close to what our limit is, you send that overhead to Greenville and let them stay in Pitt County. We would be better off, especially if you've got money you want to burn or you want to raise taxes for some reason, help Belhaven secure a hospital. Thank you.